divine providence is in full bloom, and its fruits are ripening. This building you see is Changchung Gymnasium, the largest and most well-known indoor gymnasium in the country. This hall normally admits 8,000 people. And now, it is 10:30 on the 21st of October, 1970. A solemn moment for the opening of the international mass wedding ceremony of 777 couples belonging to the Holy Spirit Association for the unification of world Christianity. This is the most sacred moment for the participants in their lives. More than 15,000 people, nearly double of the accommodation capacity, swarmed to the spot, and yet many good wishers could not enter the hall because of the packed crowds in front of the building. Many newsmen and correspondents were engaged busily in their activities. Fireworks embroidered the sky with all the colors of the rainbow and helped to draw the hearts of 5 million Seoulites to this gigantic celebration. This is, to be sure, the largest joint wedding ceremony in the history of mankind. The hall is decked with the flags of all nations, and the atmosphere in the hall turned more festive. Now a historic moment has come. Mr. Jongbok Hong, one of the regional directors of the association, is presiding at the ceremony. The resounding fanfare of the Republic of Korea Navy Band signaled the start of new life of 1,580 brides and bridegrooms. Now, flags of the 10 participating nations entered the auditorium proudly. Mr. Yong-Hui Kim, president of the association, addressed guests, parents, and relatives of the new couples, explaining the significance of the joint wedding ceremony. Following the introduction, 48 best men entered the hall. They are the blessed couples who had married in the same mass wedding years before. Now the officiators are entering the hall. Mr. Son Myung Moon and his wife took their stand. They are the founders of the Unification Church and the religious parents of the brides and bridegrooms. They stand opposite to each other on the center of the front platform, specially arranged for this occasion. Two maids in white are standing beside them, holding the bowls filled with holy water. On the special guest stand, there are hundreds of dignitaries. They are witnessing each moment of the historic ceremony and are extending their unsparing good wishes to the participants. Now the brides and bridegrooms are entering the hall. Today, on this wedding ceremony, we might say this entrance of the brides and bridegrooms is the most impressive one. A long train of them covered 1/2 mile, and it took a whole hour for all the couples to complete lining up. As they pass the stand where the officiators are standing, holy water is sprinkled on them by their leader couple for their blessing. They came from 10 different countries of the East and the West. Korea, Japan, Free China, the United States, England, Germany, France, Italy, Austria, and the Netherlands. And of them, 539 couples from Korea, 235 couples from Japan, 16 from Europe and America, totaling 790 couples in actual number. They differ in race and color, and also have different backgrounds of culture, history, and traditions, as well as different languages. In spite of their differences, however, they have the same object, the same views of life, and share the same hearts and feelings which spring out from God's real heart and will. They are the young devotees who have absolute faith in God and dedicated themselves for the establishment of the kingdom of heaven on earth. Thank you. they may not be fully understood by other people who do not know divine providence well. But they are confirmed that they are the ones who should devote themselves for the fulfillment of God's will, determining to follow the way as God directs. They made their friendship deeper and wider while they worked in the same field with the same ideal and common objects. Amid blessings from 15,000 well-wishers, there still goes on the endless entrance of the brides and bridegrooms. They are the proud young couple from all over the world who have come to Korea, fatherland of their faith, to receive God's blessing. They are the proud members of the Unification Church. Is it not most fitting to say that the mind of the audience is picturing every motion of the brides and bridegrooms, and the feeling and air in the hall are much the same as a chorus by which youth is harmonized with blessing? A great march in soul towards heaven on earth must be a historic scene. Each couple passed between the officiators to have blessing and fill the spacious room one by one. Next followed questions and answers. They were asked if they would preserve faith and tradition as a blessed family throughout their life and even through eternity. And they promised to lead a life of an exemplary family. Pledges after the officiator's solemn blessing and prayer. Brides and bridegrooms exchanged wedding gifts. Finally, the officiator proclaimed the completion of marriage. Next, a representative couple of the newlyweds presented a bouquet of flowers to the officiator's couple. A gift list was presented to them. Congratulatory addresses were delivered by many dignitaries. Minister of Culture and Information of Korean Government and the National Assembly Representative, In Soo-yuk, gave their congratulatory speeches. Nobusuke Kishi, former Prime Minister of Japan, has sent a congratulatory message to be read by his representative. Mr. Ryoichi Sasakawa, a prominent leader in Japan's political and financial society, attended the ceremony and gave an ardent address to the audience. He then shook hands with the couples in the front row. His wife, Mrs. Shizue Sasakawa, has sung a poem to commemorate the blessing. As the ceremony drew near to the end, all brides and bridegrooms turned to four directions and gave a deep bow to the audience. The officiators led three cheers for the prosperous future of the 777 blessed couples. As the officiators and the brides and bridegrooms withdrew the hall, the largest wedding ceremony in history was brought to completion. It must be of great significance to review the short history of the joint wedding ceremony of the Unification Church. Unification Church places a great importance in the blessed family because it is the foundation for the realization of God's blessings to man on earth. It also puts a great importance to the joint wedding ceremony in various meanings. Let's have a brief look at its history. There was a three-couple wedding ceremony in 1960, 33 couples in 1961, 72 couples in 1962. All these ceremonies were held at the headquarters church in Cheongpa-dong, Seoul. In 1963, 124 couples were married. In 1968, 434. Both weddings were performed in the Grand Hall of the Citizens Auditorium. After the last ceremony, today, wedding of 790 couples is taking place here at Changchun Gymnastic Hall. The stadium was literally packed. Now, the brides and bridegrooms boarded on 42 buses. Over 50 buses were chartered. Car parade began. You might call it a short honeymoon trip en masse. The parade left Changchun Stadium, passed Korea Anti-Communism League headquarters, and came to Itaewon. After crossing First Han River Bridge, the buses circled around Yeouido Island, then crossed Second Han River Bridge and came back into Seoul. Parade passed by Shincheon, Sodaemun, Yongcheon, and Dongnimmun Gate through Sajik Tunnel. Then parade went up on Inwang Skyway and Pukak Skyway to come down to Donamdong and Shinseoldong to circle around eastern suburbs of Seoul, over to Yaksudong Hill, back to stadium where they started. Here, couples headed to their wedding receptions with their relatives and friends. There were again the scenes of commemoration. Fireworks lighted the sky of Seoul with bright color. At 7:30 in the evening began night program. Comedian Kyu Suk Kwak, better known as Flyboy, appeared along with many noted entertainers. The show was composed of various entertaining programs and everybody enjoyed it very much. Traditional fan dance of Korea was led by famous dancer Miss Young Suk Han. Traditional song by Miss So-hee Kim. It was followed by Kayagum, played by the students of Korean Art School, led by Mrs. Yong-hee Lee. Oh, spectacular farmer dance was performed by the dancing group of Korean Art School. The second half of the evening program consisted of modern songs and comedy. They were accompanied by Kil Ogyun's band. The evening reached its climax when singer Sang-guk Kim sang a well-known popular song. Miss Hoon Hee Chung, one of the best singers in Korea, also gave a nice song. Mrs. Sasakawa sang another poem in Japanese. Seoul's top comedian Flyboy and Bongsu Koo played a short comedy. Popular singer Sang Yu Han sang too. Four-man vocal team, the Bong Bong, also presented amusing songs. Sun Hyung Yu, one of the bridegrooms, played saxophone. Jung Hyun Park, one of the brides, sang a solo. Soo Eun Kim, a singer of the United Family, sang a congratulatory song too. Flyboy displayed his specialty, his ability of imitation of the sound of machine gun, airplane, and bombing enchanted the audience. Comedian Song Hae performed a short play. The subject was a quack bar. The brides from Japan sang in unison. Then, all the brides and bridegrooms of Japan joined in singing. European members also sang a song in chorus. The brides and bridegrooms of the United States sang several American songs. Evening mellowed into night. time went on, the programs had to be laid off. The grand finale of historic joint wedding of 777 couples was marked when all the audience, including the brides and bridegrooms, sang Korean national anthem in unison.